On Friday afternoon, Donald Trump shared a video on Truth Social that included an image of President Biden hogtied in the back of a pickup truck. That is what the former president of the United States shared to millions of people of his political rival. Now, I don't need to sit here and tell you that this is wrong. You know that. I don't need to sit here and tell you why this is wrong, because we understand that. We know how Donald Trump uses violent rhetoric, violent images at times, to try to get his base riled up to go and do something horrific. But what I will tell you is that when asked about this by reporters, Donald Trump's campaign spokesperson Stephen Chung said this: "That picture was on the back of a pickup truck that was traveling down the highway. Democrats and crazed lunatics have not only called for despicable violence against President Trump and his family, they're actually weaponizing the justice system against him." So rather than say, hey, yeah, he probably shouldn't have done that, or I don't know anything about it, you'd have to ask him, the spokesperson defended it. And he defended it with nothing but lies. Are there random people online that are on the left that have probably called for violence against Donald Trump? Absolutely. I'm not going to dispute that whatsoever. But they aren't running for office. Okay? Do you see the difference there? I don't think Mr. Chung is smart enough to understand the difference. Now, if President Biden were to share an image of Donald Trump hogtied thrown in the back of a pickup truck, then yeah, we'd be having a very different conversation today. But no elected Democrat is doing these kinds of things. I mean, Kathy Griffin got canceled for showing her graphic image of Donald Trump, sure. But Kathy Griffin's not running for office. Kathy Griffin's actually on a 40-state tour right now. But coming from an actual candidate for the highest office in the land, I would think that Mr. Chung would understand that, yeah, this is probably not appropriate. But of course, like everybody else in Trump's orbit, all he can do is lie about what's going on to justify their own actions. Now, here's the other part of this. My question, again, I'm not going to sit here and tell you that it's wrong or why it's wrong, because we all know that. My question is, who the F is this supposed to appeal to? Right? Do you honestly think there's any suburban voter out there in America, in any city, red, blue, doesn't matter, purple? Do you think there's any American who was on the fence about Donald Trump who sees this image and says, oh, well, I guess I'm going to vote for him now? So politically speaking, what was the motivation for this? Because you don't gain a single new voter from it. You do, however, run the risk of turning off millions of people. And I'm willing to bet there are plenty of people who are already now turned off. So Mr. Chung, as Donald Trump's spokesperson, maybe you could speak to him and let him know that, hey, haha, funny image, right? I know conservatives are actually selling stickers featuring that image already, but you're not going to win people over with this. Your base already hates Biden, okay? We don't have to get them to hate him more because they're already not going to vote for him. What you have to do, where you're struggling the most, is with these average everyday people, and all you're doing is pissing them off and alienating them. But Mr. Chung, as I said, is not smart enough to do that. So he's going to keep lying for Donald Trump, and essentially, they're going to dig the campaign's own grave because they're too stupid to realize that imagery like this isn't going to win over a single voter that's on the fence. Well, folks, we have crossed that 1 million subscriber milestone, but rest assured, we are just getting started here at Ring of Fire. So if you're not already, please do subscribe to the channel and make sure to like, share, and comment on the videos.